Well, hey everyone, all my little peeps that might follow my channel just right now, or maybe occasional strangers that encountered my channel for some odd reason, some some maybe unknown reason, because what I'm doing here and kinda not, it's not kinda related to anything activity, it's more about me. It's less of a lesson, it's more like a practice for myself. And you see, I'm not quite clean-shaved here, but you will have to live with it. And please bear with all this, that I miss my front teeth and all the shit that goes along these lines. And it's kind of my personal space where I'm doing my practice, belonging to my English soul. My English soul resides within me, and it's never been out of it. And all my life track that I'm following, only this particular moment, I should say, I feel kind of special, kind of touch from outside, from heavens, I should say, that I should study more, learn more, and immerse myself into deepest and more ragged version of brilliant American version of English language, where I'm about to find myself in the nearest future. And I am still on it, and I'll be continuing my shit as long as I can live. As long as I can live, please bear with all these mispronouncing things that occur to me here and there, and those hurdles that challenged me in my way up in terms of how I learn English and how I sound and how I do on general my English related standpoint, and how I approach my life and how I approach my just to study angles, whatever it be related to. And let's say, I don't know, maybe a couple of years ago, maybe three, let's see what timeline it covers. I guess it's been now a 3.5 years as I branched out, and I kind of quit it and stopped doing regular things in my life, my routine lifestyle, I should say. I quit it being a simple salesman, and I kind of feel the push inside me that urged me to do something more significant, more crucial within my life track. And we are all here have only one life track as a human being, as a physical entities here. We only have as a physical entities here, we all have only one life track. Correct me if I'm wrong, I might be mistaken here. If you're just related to some parallel universes, or you follow just several life tracks simultaneously, please comment down below and put your own opinion as for this point. And since it's my channel, it's my part of your personal universe here, we can do whatever, right, along with you. If you're my viewer, you might be just to be on the same picture, in the same picture, I should say, that I am, that I'm in. And let's say I'm more about here speaking related to my spontaneous speech as it goes, without any just preparatory ground or any side thoughts in my head, pre-mapped things in my head, without them at all. And I switch the camera on, I turn the switch up, and that's when the camera commenced to film me. And let it be my footage of today, I don't know, whatever it would be, where this video track might go, I don't even know. I don't fucking know, really. I'm just giving you this stream of consciousness that's spilling out of me, and I can do that. I don't know how many minutes, how many hours I can do this shit. And if you were along beside my shoulder, let's say, or just beside me right now, you might be wondering how I'm doing this shit. And I tried several times to do that in my native language, and I kind of failed because I ran out of thoughts even without commencing that shit. And I commenced, actually, and it followed for, I don't know, maybe 1 minute and a half, and I stopped. I ran out of any words in my native language, and I started to just recall how it was in my English as I instigated these activities earlier with ranting in English. And I'd never done that previously in my native language before I started doing that in English. Then I realized that the practice solves everything, because I hadn't been practiced previously to do the same shit in my native language, and without any practice, I could barely able to do that. And that was the signpost of not being able to proceed those ramblings of, in my native language. Sorry for misspelling some points here, and I'm only learning, and I adore this shit that when it happens to me, and when it happens like randomly, spontaneously. I do know I look corny here, and I wear pretty corny cap and corny stuff, like chain made out of silver, some metal thing on me, and I adore wearing silver things, and I never wore actually like golden ones, because I really think that's corny to wear huge, like very thick gold made chains and laces and stuff like that, you know what I'm saying? And I just started to think that why not to put my nicest cap on and to make this rambling shoot off today, and I'm doing that, I don't know how, it's up for you to judge me, but don't judge too severely and without knowing the entire picture what happens while you're just speaking and studying your, it's not even more like second language to me, I only stretch in my ability as for my speaking. I was given advice, I don't know, maybe half a year ago, and there was some Native American guy in my life, and he gave me kind of piece of advice that goes as follows: Alex, you should speak more. You already like know a bunch of words, and your vocabulary is not so bad. It's not how bad, as he said. And the only thing you should follow and should do, and you would be doing if you want to learn and sound like a Native American, is when you want to practice more, want to speak more, even in front of myself, adorable me. And that's how it goes, without, in the absence of any other people around me to speak with. Correct me if I'm wrong. If you might just speaking with a random people, allegedly surrounding you while they're not there, it's kind of a separate issue, because it's like called the multi-personality disorder thing. I'm not that kind of guy at all. I'm only following my just stream of consciousness as it goes, as it spill out of me, and I'm kind of having this slight script in my head as it sticked deeply into my mind, I should say, and I should follow these tiny lines within that list of mine where I have these tiny things that I'm about to speak about. I adore these reiteration of things within certain grammar point, and I kind of noticed that I kind of tend to use more sophisticated and more complete and more profound and in-depth version of English. The more I speak, the more I tend to use that and to do that, I should say, correct me. And if you're in the picture of the same activity that I am immersed into, then you know better what to do, right? I'm not here to teach you, I'm not holding you in this place, and please just bear with all this shit that as it goes, without any side thoughts, without any strict opinions about my activities here. Okay, let's keep it just simple and nice and understood, and just follow as it goes, as I said previously. And guys, what would you like me to speak about here? And let's say I've done today my current just rambling speaking practice at a local venue called Local Mormon Church, and we were all gathered, all the peeps were gathered together, and we were doing our just current activities of today, and we were just composing some kind of rambling story about how it would be acting in a certain way if some shit happened to us in a certain way. And I try to understand as clear as I could and how it really goes, and it really was that way. We were proposed to pick some random items out of list written on the blackboard, and those items were about to save us from some pernicious situations, like let's say we were given certain situation that we were about to get rid of, and we were trying to use those like items out of that list and to get them together and to compose something meaningful to handle, to cope with that situation, to just eliminate that dangerous and pernicious situation that occurred to us that during that speaking, whatever, rambling practice, whatever you would call it. For me, it's like more like and less of a speaking practice, more like a rambling practice, as I'm just standing in front of some audiences and I'm ranting without stopping, and I'm figuring out the shit as it goes. While it's going, I'm reiterating shits while it's going, and I'm composing new shits while the old one's going on, and that's when the inspiration comes to me, and I start to feel something that I have to speak more, and I have to speak like this way. I may go on a tangent at some points, and that lures me. My English lures me as I learn more. It lures me further on, and I go on a tangent. I go up, and that shit reiterates again and again, and finally I get to the same track where I was previously, and I kind of. And I was about to finish and wrap up my story and to make it clear to the other people that might be dropping their ears to my rambling shit that was spread around, and all those lit peeps were just, oh my god, what a nice story, what a nicest shit we ever heard, you know what I'm saying? And guys, I guess that's it about today. That's been my current practice. Slightly higher rate of speech, and I try to be as clear, as fluent as I could, and that's it. Take care and be yourself and do whatever you want, no matter what they say, and that's it. Take care, have a nice one, see y'all, bye.